to go something like this.
Until the church allows people to see them as people, the church can never attain maturity. Now hear me and hear me well. Now this is not because of any conversation, but listen to me. The reason I want people, now you can't stop people, they show respect, you know, Pastor Rodrick, that's fine. But you know what? Y'all ready for this? The servant is not greater than his Lord. Peter, Ezekiel, Samuel, Ruth, Micah, Moses. I speak as an apostle. Jesus, we call him Jesus all the time. And if you think it's disrespect to call a man by his first name, you are already trapped in religion. Prove me wrong. Get the Bible and throw it at me. But be ready to spend 2 hours in truth. Jesus! Jesus! Bishop Jesus! Reverend Jesus! Doctor Jesus! Pastor Jesus! Prophet Jesus! Let me say something. Oh, I want y'all to have it right. I want you to have it right. What I am saying, nobody knows who anybody is. We have lost our identity. You understand? And that's why people are hurt when this bishop falls. Because they don't see the man, they see the bishopric. They see the prophet. They see the pastor. See, and see, we put it out there like that. Folk will have more feelings for you if they knew you by your first name. Okay. Now, God says, Abraham, I'm going to make your name great. And God spoke to me and said, Rodrick, if I'm going to make your name great, people got to know how to say Rodrick. That's what he told me. Now, I'm not that deep. But that's what he said to me. Rodrick Owensby. No middle name. He's making that name great because I allow my name to be my name. And a great name, I'm trying to help you, is to be chosen rather than riches. And see, when you get caught up, I'm talking to everybody, when you get caught up in that name stuff, you don't even allow people to be people. How would I look at the house saying, Prophetess Apostle Katrina, Dove, Baby, Snook Snook, and I ain't gonna tell you all the rest of them. Now let me get back over here. Tring Tring, Peach Cobbler. She know what those names mean. She can write it down. Because every one of them got different meaning. And Lord, if I say, hey, God, about that, when I say, there's a revival coming. Church, sanctification. Hallelujah time. I am to honor and dwell with her according to knowledge. There's no business greater than marriage. Because marriage affects generations. Right? And some of y'all so busy trying to make each other become each other until you lose the essence of romance in your relationship. My wife is a mirror that reflects me, who I am. I'm her mirror. So my job is not to make her Rodrick. She's already Rodrick. I'm already Katrina. We let each other be ourselves. I value her very thought. When she talks, I look at her as though God himself is talking. I pay attention to every word that falls from her lips. There's no show. It's just how we are. Why? Because she's my buddy. She's my friend. That's my girl. And folk get married and lose all. See, if I start treating her religiously, then I'm going to miss out who she really is. I'm going to stop seeing her as my lady, my lover, and my friend. So I'm not going to put a religious aura over her.
You know, it's just something about it. I can't explain it. But it goes something like this.
About you now.